Documentary-style video editors are making thousands of dollars each month. Many of you also requested that we should make a documentary-style video editing course. So, today we are starting a documentary-style video editing course, free for all of you. We work hard to bring these courses to you at no cost, and in return, we want feedback. Make sure to like the videos and comment below to suggest improvements. Let's learn how to make the map animation effect, which you just saw. You can use this style to make the hook of your videos. First, we need a map screenshot of our destination. Head over to Google Earth and find the place on which you are making the video. I found this place more suitable for making it highlighted. Zoom out. You see these names over the map, and we want a clean map, so click Layers at the bottom right and select Clean. With that done, we have a clean map we can use for our animation. Take a screenshot and save it. To get other elements like clouds and a yellow highlighter, head over to canva.com and search for clouds. Select some different types of clouds and download them with a transparent background. Take out some more variations for a more realistic sky effect. Remember to download all with a transparent background. For the highlighter color, remove the clouds and change the color of the canvas to yellow and download it, but not with a transparent background. To get a jet, search for Top View Jets, bring the image to Canva and remove its background. Then readjust it and download it with a transparent background. Now I know the hassle of finding assets, and it takes a lot of time to build your own library of music, fonts, and effects. That's why I have this premium documentary editing pack, which has everything you need. Overlays, cinematic fonts, LUTs, VFX, sound effects, and even original music composed by me. All assets are copyright-free and royalty-free, meaning no licensing hassles. For just $10, you get a complete toolkit to enhance your edits with high-quality resources. Check the link in the description to grab it now. Now, back to the video. Bring all the resources into the CapCut project. First, bring the map to the main timeline and increase its length according to your need. For the zoom effect, add a keyframe at the start of the footage, then move to the end and scale it to your desired ending frame. I think that looks good. So we have a smooth zoom effect. Next, bring the clouds into the above layers in a stack and do some adjustments so they cover the main targeted area on the map, which we want to highlight later. Increase its length to match the map footage. We are at the ending frame, so here our targeted area should be revealed. Move the clouds to the edge of the scene and add a keyframe. Similarly, do this for each layer of clouds. Moving to the beginning of the timeline, select the cloud layer. Move the clouds to a place where they completely cover the targeted area, and add a keyframe there. We've achieved a good revealing and zoom effect. Bring in the jet and make it the same length. Adjust its size and position to make it fly over the target area from the bottom right corner to the top left corner. Move to the timeline where you want the jet to complete its flyover animation. I find this place good to end the jet animation, so add a keyframe here and make sure the jet is out of the screen at this point. Then, move to the beginning of the clip and move the jet to its starting point where you want its animation to start. simply copy this layer and paste it to get two jets flying over the targeted area. Just adjust the second jet layer to the right side of the first jet to get this type of jet flyover. It looks good. It's time to highlight the targeted area with yellow. Find a good position on the timeline for the highlighted area to appear. I think it looks good here when the jets are halfway into the scene. Bring in the yellow frame at that point and increase its length. Then, go to Blend Mode in the Video tab to reduce the opacity of this layer, as we want to see the area under this highlighted layer. To get only the targeted area highlighted, go to Mask and select the Pen Masking. Trace out the area. Find a suitable position where the area highlighting animation completes and add a keyframe there under the Masking tab. Moving the player to the start of the layer, increase the feather to get a good water-like spreading effect, and move the masking points to the center so that we get this growing effect on highlighting. But the mask is zooming in with the targeted area. To fix that, make this layer a compound layer and add a keyframe at the end of the clip where it fully covers the targeted area. At the start, also add a keyframe. And we get this so far. It's pretty good. We want the map to turn black and white when the highlighted area appears. To do that, select the map layer and find the position where you want the map to turn black and white. So go to the Adjustment tab and add keyframes over saturation. You can adjust the exposure as well to get a good black and white effect. It's looking good. It's time to add text. Go to the Text tab and add text. Enter the name of the area you want. I am naming it MO Zone. Choose a font. I'm going with Arial Black and adjusting its size. Also, add a second text and choose a different font. I'm going with the default. Readjust it. Add an animation to the text. Go to the Animation tab. I'm going with the typewriting animation for both. Adjust its timing according to yourself. I am delaying the secondary text animation time to get a good effect. The text is not zoomed in with the map. To fix this, select both and create a compound clip. Add zooming keyframes to match the map zoom timing. Then, to get a blur effect on the edges while the zooming effect is happening to make it more realistic, go to the Effects tab and add the hazy effect over the whole timeline. Adjust the blur value according to yourself, or you can copy mine. Lastly, add sound effects to get more realism. That's how you can make interesting hooks for your documentary-style edits. We will keep adding new tips and tricks tutorials for documentary video edits, so make sure to subscribe to this channel and like the video.